Hi. Good evening. How are you guys? Welcome to Tangle and Inspire. My name is Aishwarya Darbha. I'm a certified Zentangle teacher. I live in Pune, India with my family. And today we are in the day 26th of Zentangle Journaling. So if you guys have come for the first time, I'd just like to give you a short intro of what we are doing. So we are creating about with very new and beautiful patterns, Zentangle patterns on our Zentangle Journal. And presently we are 200 plus people creating beautiful artwork in our group. We have a Facebook group named Tangle and Inspire Club. I have put the links in the description. You can just read about it. And you can also visit my website blog, where I have posted on how we are going to do, what is the inspiration behind it. So that is it. And we are doing our May 31 days, that is Zenlock 31. We call this as May 2020. It's because 31 days of Zentangle journaling we are doing. And we are presently in our day 26th. So, okay, let me go, start with the tangle. And this is a very beautiful pattern from my friend Ayame. From my friend Emiko. And the tangle name is Ayame. And so let me just start with how this tangle is about. So this is a very beautiful radial pattern. And just start like a leaf pattern over here. Okay, it's just a simple S, and then you just aura or trace the same thing back again. Once again, you turn the tile and start with a curve S, and we trace it back again. So something about this pattern which is very beautiful. Ayame is like, she feels that the pattern looks quite similar to a flower pattern called iris. And Ayame also stands as a flower explanation, like a botanical term. And what it is about hope, determination, courage. It's all about all the goodness that we presently need. So let us look into this, and it's like, it's really nice to have some hope, courage, especially that we are going through such a tough time all over the world. So she has created about three, I have one sample piece here that I created a few days back. So she created about three leaf patterns and then kept on auraing it. I just want to go about a little more just to show that you can do a lot of variations out of it. So I'm just doing four or five, whatever you feel like. So however you feel like the space. And then we just start, we take a like a flux thing and you bring it back. Okay. Once again, like a petal shape, and you come back. And once again, come back. So you meet all the lines meet in the same it intersects in the same area. Okay, and here I end it. So you can just go about, like, you can start taking from the long. That is how she has shown it. That is, it starts from the larger to the smaller. So you can also create like that. And then once again, start here. And then you once do it. You can check out tanglepatterns.com to see how new other variations that she has shown. Or else, if you want to come up with your own variations, if you want to do a tangle variations, you're free to do out with that. But for video purpose, I'm just doing the same thing that she has done it. And yeah, if I go a little bit wild, I may go for my variations as well. So guys, how was your day today? How have you been doing? I've been watching a lot of comments, lots of beautiful artworks that you've been posting on the Facebook. And I'm really very glad and happy. Just a bit tied up here, so that's the reason I'm not able to take much time to comment on your artwork. So sometimes it gets delayed. But please, guys, I really love watching your. You know, I can't believe that this thing is happening and we are all journaling together. So this is very beautiful. I'm enjoying actually each and everything that you are posting. And please continue so because it inspires me for the next day. I think about what pattern that I want to create, how to what to do, you know, for the next coming days also. So that is something that I also need. So that's a lovely encouragement. So if you are just, you know, you just did one tangle or you are just sketching it about, please do that. Please post all those works as well. So it gives me a good idea of how you guys are enjoying it or what you're doing. Okay, so what she has shown us before I go into this variation, I just want to tell you. So what she has done is that she has created, she has sectioned this into two. So I'd also like to do that. Okay, and so this is how she has done, and then she just keeps on shading it. And but I would like to just give some variations to mine. So you can create something like this, you know, and this looks beautiful with some little small orbs in the center. So you can have your own variations like this. So if you come up with some pattern, you can put it within this leaf form. So Zentangle is all about abstract art and it's very nice. You can just enhance your creativity as you go about it. So, and just to give a bit of twist, let me just put this. Okay, so this is how I think it all comes quite similar, and this is the basic pattern that is in. And then she has shown that she has created a lot of lines, shadings. So I have also used it on my tile, and you can watch till here or you can go about. I just want to show how I will shade and put my videos. So I hope my camera is stable. So my table gets a bit shaky and the camera starts hurting. So I got a new setup today. If you find the lighting is better and the video quality is better, it's all because I got a new lighting setup here with a new tripod, and it's working very well. I feel it's good. So if you are wondering what tools I am using today, I am using my Artline pen. This is an Indian brand, and it's a nice pen from the brand. But there are some drawbacks to this point, is that the ink gets completed very quicker, and it's quite short. If you compare it with Micron, you can see it here. So once again, this is my computer. Okay. So see, It's a bit shorter, though it looks the same size, but I can really feel that the ink gets completed in this faster, and the drying times is is slow. So the micron pens drying time is faster. So if you put draw and you touch it, or it doesn't smudge. In this, you have to be a little careful. And this says that it is water-based, water-resistant, but it is absolutely not. If I put water, it will start spreading. Even after one day or 2 days, keeping on dry and put and I apply a little watercolor or watercolor wash, I see the ink running out. So that is the that is one more con of it. But for a plain tile, I think it is good, and I find it convenient because it is quite lighter. I feel it is quite lighter, and for my broad fingers and short hand, the grip is better. I enjoy this grip, and especially on a bit rougher tile. This is a bit rougher tile. I don't sell this off. Earlier I used to keep it. So that is it. So I have stock of all the Zentangle tiles and materials. If you guys want to stock it up, because now the lockdown has opened and we don't know when next is going to come. So if you want to purchase a new stock, you can DM me, or you can WhatsApp me through my Tangle and Inspire page. Or so I'll let you know the prices and everything. And yeah, I'm planning to put up all the prices and list very soon on the page. So once I find time, I think I'll put it. But it is already with me. I'm unable to find time to do extra things. So now what I'm doing is I'm creating this kind of a little darker shade on the top. So I feel it is nice to do that. I'm just filling it and making it a bit thicker line. So you can do so many things of these sorts. So these are just some examples that I want to create. So that is it, guys. And so I'm using Zentangle pencil also, or is it 2B pencil? This is a very short pencil, it's very nice, convenient to draw, especially shade on the Zentangle tiles. So the grip is better. Also, you have more control over the shading. So I have found, especially people who are not doing much of shading, that their pencil lines go away and then everything gets very dark and smudgy. So this is something that you can avoid with a short pencil. So this is made from a general pencil company. It's a wonderful company, actually. It has been providing pencils past 400 years. And so they're really good. The pencil is very, the lead is really pure. And just a little bit of it is enough. You don't have to put more also. So you can use that also. And I use Tortillon for smoothening. So these are all the tools and materials. These are very basic tools and materials for Zentangle. And I trust me, it goes a very long way. You don't need so many tools to learn Zentangle, to create art. And that's what I love about Zentangle, is they make everything little, very simplified. Small 3.5-inch tiles, a pencil, and a Tortillon. That's it. You need only these products to go along, and you can create art anywhere, anytime. So, no hassles of carrying colors and everything. And of course, you are free to carry your color pencils and wherever you go or whatever you do, because if you feel like doing art or painting or coloring, you can enjoy it. But for basic drawings, for your meditative art, this is the best thing to draw. So, I'm just putting shading a bit here and there, just a little touch up. You can see that I'm not even thinking what I'm doing. But I am not thinking, but I'm definitely paying attention to what I'm doing. So, Zentangle is all about mindful meditation. to smooth this out, you can use your thumb. It's just that if you have graphite on your and you touch it anywhere, it will become dark. But you can use your fingers if you want to. I like to use tortillon. It's called tortillon on stump. So guys, I would like to know what tools and materials that you use for your Zentangle. I think it's a nice that all of us know, the audience here that who come back, they know that what you guys you use for artworks, and it will be a good information for them. And I think I'll also like to explore if I can see how best it is. So you tell me what tools and materials you have. Do you use the local materials or do you use the good quality, high quality one? So I always use Micron. That is my go-to thing. I don't carry Artline or any other pen. And I find other companies' pen a bit more expensive. Like the Staedtler is very expensive for India. Those Staedtler pens are very common. So I haven't purchased any of the Staedtler pen. And I find that pen to be very heavy, and I have begun to hold my pen lightly just recently. So heavy pen doesn't really go along with me. I need a little lighter pen so I can hold lightly, and my pen, my ink can just flow. This is Ayame for you, and thank you so much for watching this. And I'll just start journaling. It won't be a voiceover for you, so you can just enjoy. Ayame. That's how I produce. I don't know how she produces it. She's a wonderful CZT. You can watch her tangles. She has also one more beautiful pattern, that is Cass. Cass is very excellent. It's a beautiful grid pattern. We'll definitely try one day and on this channel. So thank you so much, guys, for joining along. And yeah, please don't go anywhere. I will start my journal. It's just that my voiceover will be over. So that's the reason I'm talking. So let us start journaling. This is my Zentangle journal. This is where I'm creating all my Zentangle art that you're seeing. So yeah. So okay, join me for the Zentangle journal.